my name's Jade, and today we will be doing the bookshelf time capsule. This was a tag created by Jessie the Reader. I will link the original down below. This has been a feat to film. The sun has not been cooperating. My bookshelves come about 2 o'clock to about now, just gone four. It depends what time of year, obviously. They're just in the sunlight, and so my spines get bleached. My Allegiant is there. It's supposed to be orange. My paper towns, supposed to be red. This has been difficult to film because of that.
My curtain is along the pole. My shelves are in disarray up there. We've been doing this for hours, so I thought it'd be nice to film it like sunset with the golden glow. And to be fair, it's more accurately sunset now.
I filmed some stuff before this and there might be shadows on the book. As I said, the window directly glares onto the shelves and there's not a lot I could do about this. If the lighting is inconsistent, I'm sorry. I really tried. Enough of me rambling on for now though, let's get into it. Where are your shelves from? I have the Billy bookcases from IKEA. It's a pretty popular bookshelf. I got it back in the day when all the booktubers I watched had these shelves. It was easy. I got them in white because my room used to be black and white. Now it's more black and so they kind of stick out a lot, but they're sturdy. They're fine. Which shelf is your favorite? That would be this shelf right here, is where my tool fantasy books typically go. But because of that, I've always liked them. I've liked the look of tool books. They're pretty. I like fantasy. They're some of my favorite books to look at. These books here, the Shadow and Bone trilogy, while I don't like the covers, the spines are gorgeous. I also have The Ring and the Crown and The Assassin's Curse and The Pirate's Wish over there, and they're really pretty. For the most part, it's always been my favorite shelf. Do you keep every book you read, or do you ditch the ones you didn't end up loving? I keep every book I read. I've not read that many books throughout my life. There's been big chunks of time where I've not been reading, and so that's less than the amount I read overall. Also, I'm a slow reader, so I don't have a huge... I have a decent collection, but it's not huge. So I, space-wise, for the most part, can afford to keep every book I read. I say that my shelves are full. I am a book collector though. I like having all the books. I study literature and creative writing. If I ever need a book for an essay, if I ever need a book to reference something as inspiration, I just like having them all, and books tend to stick with me quite well, and so I like having it to go back to it. There's very few books that I hate, so there's not any book on my shelf that I don't feel justified having. The only exception I think is I've gotten rid of some of the books I read as a kid because I just didn't have space to keep them all and I wasn't ever gonna read them again. What do you do when your bookshelves fill up? Panic, cry, stare at them and hate them. I just recently reorganized my TBR shelves, which is why I'm filming this video now. I will reorganize them and reorganize them again until I can get them to fit. And that doesn't work, you know, stacking the books. I tend to stack books, stack them until I can't stack them anymore, until it hits the top shelf. I have random books floating around on top of other books. I have books behind books. Mostly they're TBR books. For instance, my school TBR is just down here. I have Twilight books behind this shelf. Midnight Sun and the 10th anniversary edition of Twilight are behind there, Life and Death. You gotta do what you gotta do. It just, I make them fit. I've got books on top of my shelf as well, and I've got my Lainey Taylor books on another shelf right now and a couple other random ones. I think eventually this whole top shelf will have to be full of books. Right now I've got some gappage and some decor. I don't think it can stay like that for long. Biggest problem with this is my school books and keeping them all and trying to force them all onto this one shelf here. Well, these two shelves here. I finally managed to get it that I've got space to grow. Like, I'm ready. I'm prepared for the new books for my next trimester to go on there. But the real answer to this question is panic and cry. What is your organization method, and what is a method you want to try? I genre, but on my terms. Like, it's not super strict. We have fantasy, and I try and make it start with like high fantasy, and then we blend into like urban fantasy, and then this is kind of magical realism, and then we kind of morph into dystopian-ish superpower type stuff, and then it continues over here with dystopian, and then we go into sci-fi, and then this is just a contemporary shelf. These are my more serious books for the most part, and then these are my more fluffy books for the most part, but also it's dependent on size and paper versus hardback. This shelf up here is adult fiction for the most part, and I have historical fiction and post-colonial fiction. I have some classics. I have some more contemporary fiction. My LGBTQ research section. Over here I have non-fiction, and then I have my plays and a little bit poetry. TBR shelves, they're organized slightly differently. I have adult TBR, and then I have tool, hardcover, TBR, mostly paperback TBR, the rest of the hardcover TBR. So it's all organized in various ways. Mostly it's either like hardback versus paperback versus sizing and genre. And then also we had Daughter Spoken Bone separately. We have some of my paranormal fiction up there. We have my graphic novels and some of my favorite adult novels and some adult classics that don't anywhere else. That section's it's a bit of a work in progress. Is there a shelf on your shelf that bothers you no matter what? Kinda. The adult TBR used to be the shelf, but I quite like it the way it's organized right now, to be fair. I think that's also to do with the fact that a lot of the books on this TBR are books that I genuinely want to read, I'm genuinely excited about, and sometimes that's not always the case. But I think the best answer is the very bottom of my left bookcase. It's kind of not really, it's got books on it, but it's not like the other ones. It's got board games, tool books and folders and random bits and bobs, cookbooks and coloring in books and random bits and bobs. And I don't like the way it looks. You can't really see that one though, so it's okay. Hopefully there'll be a day where that stuff isn't with my book collection. For now, it has to be there. Which color dominates your bookshelf? I struggled with this one a little bit. I do have a lot of orange books, especially up here for some reason. I think the answer there was black/gray/brown. It's hard because there's a lot of dark books that are just like bleh colors, like the Throne of Glass. They're all different colors, but they kind of melt together into this bleh dark color. And so that's kind of what there is a lot of on my shelf. Does that count? That's the answer I'm giving. So it's gonna have to count. What's the most damaged book on your shelf, and a story time as to why? I have two Romanian rescue dogs. We got Star first. She's a bit of a wild one, and it took a while to get into her, the fact that she can't chew everything up. Freya, our newest one, she's not there yet. Star's better now, and it's kind of unbelievable because she was so bad for so long, but she's better than Freya, so she's gotten better. I was always so careful about leaving books out where dogs could reach them. She'd eaten and destroyed various other like school books and stuff, and it always annoyed me, but like it's okay, it's just a school book. When I ordered The Reckoning of Noah Shaw, it came signed. And I didn't order a signed one, and it made me really excited. And I left it on my bed with my door open. And she ate it like she's eaten no other of my books. I was so upset about it that my boyfriend bought me a new one. And so now I have a nice pretty edition, and I have the ruined edition that I'll probably keep forever just to remember her by, remember the story by. She didn't mean it, but it's like so within her character, she's such a little terror. And getting it down, let me tell you, was not easy, because graphic novels, I don't know if you know this, they're really heavy, and they don't like to stand up. Unless they're like forced in a shelf, they don't like to stand up. And so I've had to weigh it down either side with heavy stuff. And I have this tin from a Lumicrate, the Daughter of Smoke and Bone tin, and I keep it in there to weigh it down. And everything just fell, and it was scary. Do you have any books with major printing errors? No. I might, but I can't think of any. The closest thing I can think of is maybe like pages that aren't as, you know, bright. They're kind of more of like gray rather than a black. The closest thing I can think of is Again But Better, where Christine talked about this in one of her videos, but they changed the ending of her acknowledgements slightly, and it's not what she originally wanted it to be. It says XOXO 2018, and I think it was supposed to be Poem the Banana Books XO. I'm not sure. But that's not quite right. That's the closest thing I can think of. What's the ugliest spine on your bookshelf that sticks out like a sore thumb? Well, we have those faded books. Remember Allegiant and Paper Towns? They're supposed to be red, and they're very not red. And every time I look at Allegiant and Paper Towns, it hurts me. Other than that, what is it even called? It's called Brothers of the Damned. It's in the spin-off to the Saga of Darren Shan, the Saga of Lartin Krepsley. The Saga of Darren Shan were some of my favorite books as a kid. I was obsessed. It's morphed me into who I am in so many ways. Like, it made me fall in love with reading, it made me fall in love with vampires and all things creepy. On the spines of the original book, the Saga of Darren Shan, there's this really cool spider image thing going on. It's so beautiful, and it like shifts, like it's holographic. It's beautiful. And they started doing that with the Lartin Krepsley books with a spider, just like the spider on the Saga of Darren Shan. And then the last book came out, and it didn't have the end of the spider legs. And I was mad, and I'd forgotten about how mad it made me. But then pulling them out reminded me, and so now I'm mad again. Like, why would they do that? Like, did they reissue the first three without the spider on at all? I don't understand, because the spider was cool. Why would they all of a sudden be against the spider? If you don't already have your dream bookshelves, what do your dream bookshelves look like? I like the ones that are kind of like built in onto the shelf. I would love it if I could have like a dark, rustic kind of wood, not a super warm wood, but that kind of like ragtag looking wood. I'd love it to look like an old apothecary or like an old tavern, or like have ivy, like the decor I have in this corner, like those kinds of vibes. I think I'd be okay with like more bully type shelves. I just wouldn't want them to be white. What is the tallest book on your shelf? The 100 Nights of Hero by Isabel Greenberg. The Encyclopedia of Early Man is the same height. They're really tall. They don't fit anywhere. I tried for ages to find different places to put them. It has to go on that ragtag shelf down there. And it's a shame because I really like those books. What is the smallest book on your shelf? That would be a tiny little edition of Throne of Glass. They have like a set of miniatures. And I saw it and I thought it was the cutest thing and I had to have it. I thought, you know, it's okay, I just get on. It's a gimmicky thing. It's fun for my collection. Now I want them all. So we'll see how that goes. What book is your most prized possession? That award goes to Wayfarer by Alexandra Bracken. This is the only personalized book I have. I can't even remember, like, Alex shared somewhere about how she was personalizing books on a specific, like, I think it was an independent bookstore, and I had to have it, and it didn't cost that much, the book itself, but like shipping it from America cost a lot of money, so it was quite expensive. And Alex is one of my favorite authors, and I love this book. It all means so much to me. I love it. What's a book that makes you slip back in time to a past memory when you see it on your shelf? It's hard because I can remember most books when I was reading them. Like, I distinctly remember reading The Fifth Wave at my dad's caravan, eating Easter eggs when I read the books, and things like that will stick with me. So it's hard to think of like a specific moment for one book. The closest thing I think I have is this one summer. I had gone to Birmingham to see Fall Out Boy in concert, and the next day we were exploring Birmingham and we went to Foyles, and I think it might have been the first Foyles I've ever been to as well. And I bought it and it was like my Birmingham book. I just didn't remember buying that one. Those are all the questions for today's video. Let me know down below your most prized possession book. I'd love to know. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have an awesome morning, afternoon, evening, / night. My name's Jade. I hope I see you again next time. Goodbye! Isabel Greenberg. The sun is like going. It's nearly gone.